Christine, family, it is clear to those of us that have worked closely with Earl and spent any time with him that he loved you and all of you so much. Those of us that have gathered here today and Earl's friends from around the world want to tell you and the family that we are so very sorry for your loss and want to thank you and the extended family for sharing Earl's life with us. It is fitting that we are gathered in this space, which many see as the house that Earl built. Since Tuesday, we have received messages and remembrances from around the world, highlighting the profound impact that Earl had on our campus, our community, and our world. But also in those messages were reflections on how Earl impacted people, how he changed how they thought of themselves as educators, leaders, and community members, seeking a common ground and working for a purpose greater than their own. On the back of your program is a message from Ethan Whitrock, an alum and author of Verses Left to Right, a poem that was commissioned for Earl's inauguration as president of St. Cloud State University in 2008. In his message, he talks about Earl's personal impact on him. He reminds us that Earl's leadership was about service to country, service to students, and service to each other. It is that simple idea that changed his and our understanding of what leadership means. Like many others in this room, the example that Earl has set is something that we will carry on for the rest of our lives. There are many memories of Earl that you will be able to see upstairs if you haven't already. If you have a moment, please do so, and you will get a sense of the impact that he had through the eyes of his friends and colleagues, including his fellow presidents. In their letter, they reminded us about the following, and I quote, "Earl was a genuine and truly caring and compassionate educator and a leader in higher education. He challenged all of us to think deeper and broader about the issues important to our students and our communities. He was a true champion of higher education and believed that it was an equalizer for many who have seen and continue to be underserved. He was a statesman, and he was the president of presidents." In the spirit of Earl's inauguration, which focused on finding common ground and working towards the common goal that we all share, we are pleased that members of our faith community are here to share with us blessings for our president and the Potter family.
Thank you. I'm a pastor here at St. Cloud State University. I lead a ministry called Kaffa Christian Fellowship, and I also serve as a volunteer police chaplain. I wanted to thank the family for your sacrifice, the time that your dad put into us and the school and the word, the world abroad. It meant a lot to me. He was a dear man, and I appreciated him a lot. I would say I loved him. He was I think you wrote it, Christine, too. He didn't know anyone that wasn't family. And that's what it really felt like. I sat across from his desk a month ago, and he was leaving the next day to come see you in Boston and meet his grandbaby. And it was super funny, because I was like, what are you gonna do this summer? And I could hardly see him. He had like piles of paper like everywhere in his entire, and it was like I could just barely see him across his desk. And I was like, what are you up to this summer? And he's like, well. So he got out of a lot of work. But I thought of him as a creative leader. I think he had vision that was far beyond a lot of what we could understand. He always thought so far in the future, and he was a dreamer. But most of all, I was thankful for his friendship. And I will miss him dearly. And so to assist in my healing, I'm going to drink Starbucks medium lattes with extra froth. Every time I went to meet him, I brought him a coffee. And didn't matter the time of day, week, didn't matter, late in the day, whatever. He was good to go. But thank you again for your sacrifice as a family. It didn't go, it'll live on for future generations. And so I've been asked to do a blessing. In Jesus' name, I stand with friends and family. Friends that are close in this community, in this state, in the world that were touched by this president. Lord, we know that you bind up the brokenhearted and you comfort those in need. Lord, would you draw near to us in our grief in the days and weeks and months and years to come, and every anniversary of Flag Day, and especially in 2 days and tomorrow, on Father's Day and the funeral tomorrow. Lord, bless us as we mourn. Lord, we take great confidence in words that come from Solomon. And he writes to us in Ecclesiastes 12:7, as the dust returns to the earth as it was, the spirit returns to God who gave it. God, you put a spirit in us, in our mother's womb, and it returns to you at the end of our days. And we know our beloved president is with you. I pray a blessing on this campus and these family members in the name of the Father and the Son.
Oh. Mole Rachamim, the Jewish prayer for the dead, followed by a brief reflection by Rabbi Alvin Fine. Exalted, compassionate God, grant perfect peace in your sheltering presence among the holy and the pure who shine with the splendor of the firmament to the soul of our dear Earl Potter, who has gone to his eternal home. Master of mercy, remember all his worthy deeds in the land of the living. May his soul be bound up in the bond of life. May his memory always inspire us to attain dignity and holiness in life. May he rest in peace, and let us say amen. Birth is a beginning, and death a destination, and life is a journey. From childhood to maturity, and youth to age. From innocence to awareness, and ignorance to knowing. From foolishness to desecration, and then perhaps to wisdom. From weakness to strength, or from strength to weakness, and often back again. From health to sickness, and we pray to health again. From offense to forgiveness, from loneliness to love, from joy to gratitude, from pain to compassion, from grief to understanding, from fear to faith. From defeat to defeat to defeat, until looking backwards or ahead, we see that victory lies not at some high point along the way, but in having made the journey step by step, a sacred pilgrimage. Birth is a beginning, and death a destination, and life is a journey, a sacred journey to life everlasting.
Bonjour. My condolences to Christine and your family. I would like to introduce a Ojibwe Dakota elder to do a prayer song, and he has asked if the immediate family could rise. You stand.
Honotakia be Wobida Tanka Pyramid or Wakantanka Tukhashida Wakantanka Oshikilapo Omakiayo Potter Oyate Potter Tiwai Ochekia Oshikilapo Omakiayo Ashti Dakota Odoan Wahantaka. Wakantanga Toka Che Waki. Welcome to Anka Toka Heo Che Waki Yeo Me Toko Yeo One Echa Toka Heo Che Waki. Welcome to Toka, Toka, hey, hey, Chewaki, hey, oh, hey, hey, hey. Welcome to Toka, Toka, hey, hey, Chewaki, hey, oh, hey, hey, hey. Me taku, hey, oh. One to ocho toka hey che waki yeo hey yeo home talk you say.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Innal hamdalillah nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nastaghfiruh. ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهد الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أرسله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على دين كله ولو كره الكافرون ولو كره المشركون. أما بعد، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. We pray in the name of Allah, Lord of the worlds, owner of the day of judgment. He alone do we worship, and He alone do we ask for help. I pray in the name of Allah to forgive Dr. Porter, to reward him with heaven, to reward him with Jannah, to forgive all his sins, to forgive all his sins, sins that he was aware of, and sins that he was not aware of. We ask Allah, this is the month of Ramadan, we ask for forgiveness. In our prayers, in our sleep, in whatever we're doing. My name is Muhammad Suma, and I'm a graduate student from St. Cloud State University. If you don't know what to say, just say Amin. Allahumma aghfir lah wa arham wa afih wa fa'anhu. Allahumma aghfir lah wa arham wa afih wa fa'anhu wa akram nuzlata wa wasi'i mudkhala wa aqsilhu bil ma'i al-salj wal barj ونقيه من القتايا كما نقيت والسول الأبيض من الدنس وأبدله دار الخير من الدار وأهل الخير من أهله وزوجه خير من زوجه وادخله الجنة وادخله الجنة وادخله الجنة يا رب العالمين وادخله الجنة يا رب العالمين وأعيذه من عذاب القبر وعذاب النار يا رب العالمين سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون والسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين.
My name is Lalita Subramanian and I will be offering a Hindu invocation in Sanskrit. न जायते म्रियते वा कदाचिन् न आयं भूत्वा भविता वा न भूयः अजो नित्यं शाश्वतोऽयं पुराणो न हन्यते हन्यमाने शरीरे This is a verse from the Hindu text, the Bhagavad Gita, chapter 2, verse 20, in which Lord Krishna imparts his divine knowledge on the nature of the soul to the despondent Arjuna, who is grieving the thought of the passing of his loved ones. Lord Krishna says, the soul is neither born, nor does it ever die, nor having once existed, does it ever cease to be. The soul is without birth, eternal, immortal, ageless. It is not destroyed when the body is destroyed. Lord Krishna establishes the eternal nature of the soul. It is ever existing beyond birth and death, devoid of all transformations. These are transformations of the body, not the self. What we call death is merely the destruction of the body, the immortal self, remains unaffected. Let us reflect and pray for strength, forbearance, deep understanding, and peace. Let us seek to be led from ignorance to truth, from darkness unto light, and from death to a timeless state of being. Om Asato Ma Satgamaya Tamaso Ma Jyotirgamaya Mrityor Ma Amritam Gamaya Om Shantihi Shantihi Shantihi.
And now I'm honored to invite Earl Harvey Potter IV to share some brief remarks on behalf of the family.
After all the stories I've heard this afternoon, it'd be easy to go off script and just talk about that and the experiences you shared with my father over these last 9 years, but I'm not going to do that because I don't think I could keep it together. So, good afternoon. My name is Earl Harvey Potter IV, but known as Binks by friends and family. First off, I wanted to say thank you on behalf of my family. Thank you. My dad was a New Englander who grew up sailing and deeply connected to the water and his family's seagoing history. So I was surprised when he told me that he was moving to Minnesota. However, I quickly grew to understand why and just how excited and happy to be here my dad was. He deeply believed in this community, the students, the faculty and staff, and community who support it, as well as the community as a whole. Coming here, he believed he could make a positive impact, and he loved the students in the school. In fact, I know he was not ready to go. He was excited about his years to come here and the work you were all doing together. My dad was passionate about this place and cared deeply about its people. We as a family have been overwhelmed by the support, love, and assistance you've shown us. Thank you again from the bottom of my heart and from my family. It has been incredibly touching, and I know my dad would have been humbled. Thank you.
As we conclude the program, please join us with the University Choir in singing the University Hymn.
Sing to the-